Welcome to ISC Plus One History class. Today we are going to start Lesson 3, Economic, Social and Cultural Impact of British Rule. First, we will go through the objectives of the lesson. The objectives are to understand the impact of modern ideas of Europe on Indian administration, reform movements in which we will study about Brahmo Samaj, Sir Syed Ahmed Khan and his Aligarh movement, the Arya Samaj movement, then struggle against caste system in which we will discuss about the contribution of Mahatma Jyotiba Phule, Narayan Guru and Vatsalingam Kandukuri. Then we will deal with the abolition of Sati rights, Widow Remarriage Act of 1858. And lastly, we will discuss Female Infanticide Prevention Act 1870, the Age of Consent 1891 and the impact of the Age of Consent Bill of 1891. And in today's session, we will discuss about the impact of modern ideas of Europe on Indian administration, and we will also discuss the reform movement called as Brahmo Samaj. Before going through our topic, we will understand the new terms. Benevolent neutrality, a policy of non-interference in the cultural and social affairs of the people by its government. Utilitarianism, the belief that the right course of action is the one that will give the greatest happiness to the greatest number of people. Rational, able to use logical thought rather than emotions to make decisions. Polytheism, the belief in more than one god. Decrite, publicly denounce. Neo-Hinduism, the revival of Hinduism on the synthesis of ancient and Western ideals in the 19th century. Here, synthesis means joining of ancient and Western ideas. And the last term is stagnation, the state of not flowing or moving. At the beginning of the 19th century, the British followed two types of policies. In the political sphere, it dominated India, but in the cultural and social affair, it adopted a policy called as benevolent neutrality that we have already done in new term. It means not to interfere in social and cultural life of the Indians. As Renaissance came in England, they developed a policy called utilitarianism in England. The administrator of England, which also came to India as to serve India, which were mainly from Haileybury College, were inspired by this utilitarianism policy. So they were in favor of bringing radical or drastic changes in India in every sphere, like social, cultural, religious sphere. So there was a controversy regarding whether to spread Western ideas in India or not to spread. So there were three schools of thought. One was conservative group, second was liberal group, and third was the utilitarian group. The conservative group was led by Warren Hastings, who served India as Governor General. He believed that Indian society should not be disturbed by the Western or alien ideas. It should be kept aloof from the Western ideas, and government should follow the policy of benevolent neutrality here. The second group, liberal group, was a view that Muslim law should be replaced by rational English law. So in courts, the Muslim law should be ended and the British law should be introduced. It also believed that the revenue should be also changed. The revenue system of India should go under the changes. But it believed that least interference should be made in the social and cultural affairs of India. It did not want any changes or want at least less changes in the social and cultural affairs of India because it can provoke Indians against the British. But the last group, the utilitarian group, which was led by Jeremy Bentham and James Mill, they were of view that reform should be introduced in every sphere of the administration. The reform should be there in society of India and cultural and religious life of India also. So inspired by this Western policy of utilitarianism, in India also, there was a reform movement led by Raja Ram Mohan Roy This reform movement was called as the Brahmo Samaj movement. Raja Ram Mohan Roy was famously called as the father of modern India or the father of Indian Renaissance due to his introduction of new ideas or his removal of superstitions from the Hindu society. He was against idolatry. Idolatry means to worship the images of God and goddesses. He did not believe in polytheism. This already we have discussed in new term. Polytheism means believing in more than one God. He believed that there is only one God. He was against casteism. He did not believe that there is any upper caste or lower caste. He believed that all people are equally created by God and we should treat them equally. He was against sati system. As a child, he had seen sati being practiced at his home. Sati was a system by which a woman was forced to die on the pyre of her dead husband forcibly. And when he was only 9 years of age, his brother died and his bhabhi was asked to perform sati. As a child, he tried to protest it, but because he was a child, he could not do anything. And at that time, he was determined that when he will get education, then after coming in India, he will go abroad. It is there that he decided that he will go outside India to get education. And when he will come back, with the help of the British, he will end this system from India. And that's the contribution of ending this system from India goes to Raja Ram Mohan Roy, who with the help of Lord William Bentinck ended this sati system in India. To bring reforms in India, Raja Ram Mohan Roy in 1814 to 1815 set up Atmiya Sabha, where he defeated fanaticism of conservative pundits and Christian missionaries. Those pundits and missionaries who believed that their religion is only supreme and all other religion are bad and they are telling the bad things to the people. He defeated them and he told that all religions treat human beings equally and all religions are basically same. In 1828, he set up Brahmo Samaj Sabha, which in 1829 came to be known as Brahmo Samaj. So his policy was to set up new Hinduism. New Hinduism is a word that we have done in the new terms. New Hinduism means he believed that there should be ancient values plus Western rational ideas. He believed in the amalgamation of our old culture and adoption of Western ideas which were based on the rational or logical thinking. So he created Brahmo Samaj in 1829. By Brahmo Samaj, he propagated that God is one, he is omnipresent, he is present everywhere. When he said God is one and omnipresent, he denounced the idea of polytheism that we should believe in more than one God. Then he used to say that God is shapeless. When he said God is shapeless, he was of view that we should not do idol worship. He was against of practicing the images of God and goddesses. His third ideal was that Vedas and Upanishads were the true source of knowledge. So he did not believe in priesthood or pandits. He has given importance to Vedas and Upanishads. He was in favor of women education. He believed that women have equal right as men to get education and to develop in society. So he denounced the parda system, which was prevalent at that time in the society. He believed that all human beings are equal. God has created them equal and we should treat them equal. When he said this idea, he discarded the caste system in India, which believed that there are some high caste people and there are some low caste people. So indirectly, he has discarded the untouchability which was going on Indian society at that time. After Raja Ram Mohan Roy left for England, the Brahmo Samaj came in the hand of Devendranath Tagore, who was the father of Rabindranath Tagore. Devendranath Tagore, for the propagation of Brahmo Samaj, founded two parties, Tata Bodhini Sabha and Tata Bodhini Patrika. The Tata Bodhini Sabha adopted the rational ideas of Western society, whereas the Tata Bodhini Patrika accepted the great ancient values. So like Raja Ramamohan Roy, Devendranath Tagore also believed in the amalgamation of Western as well as Indian ideas. Brahmo Samaj got one more person called as Keshav Chandra Sen, who have served this association for a long time. Keshav Chandra Sen joined Brahmo Samaj in 1858. He was more inclined towards the Western ideas, whereas Devendranath Tagore was more inclined towards the ancient values. Keshav Chandra Sen believed that Brahmo Samaj was a movement outside Hinduism. It was based on the Western ideas, whereas Devendranath Tagore believed that Brahmo Samaj was a movement to revive Hinduism. It was a movement in Hinduism. So there was a controversy between these two followers of Brahmo Samaj. Keshav Chandra Sen was more inclined toward the Western ideas, whereas Devendranath Tagore was more influenced by the ancient ideas. So because of the controversy, the Brahmo Samaj was divided into two parts. Sadharan Brahmo Samaj was the name of the association which was under Keshav Chandra Sen, and the Devendranath Tagore Brahmo Samaj was known as Adi Brahmo Samaj. So Brahmo Samaj was divided into two parts: Sadharan Brahmo Samaj, led by Keshav Chandra Sen, and Adi Brahmo Samaj, led by Devendranath Tagore. This association, which was led by Keshav Chandra Sen, the Sadharan Brahmo Samaj, became more popular in India, because at that time, and especially in Bengal, the Renaissance was going on. So people were more inclined towards the Western ideas. So as compared to the Devendranath Tagore's Adi Brahmo Samaj, the Sadharan Brahmo Samaj became more popular in India. Further, this Sadharan Brahmo Samaj was divided into two parts. One was Sadharan Brahmo Samaj, and second was Navabidhan Brahmo Samaj, which was led by Keshav Chandra's follower. There was a controversy that this person, Keshav Chandra Sen, he was against child marriage, but he married his 13-year-old daughter to a rich zamindar. Due to that, the Sadharan Brahmo Samaj was divided. The followers of Keshav Chandra Sen, they remained in the Sadharan Brahmo Samaj, and it was named as Sadharan Brahmo Samaj. And those people who were with the Keshav Chandra Sen, who were the at present the Keshav Chandra Sen's follower, they formed its different sect called as Navabidhan Brahmo Samaj. So it was divided into two different parts. Now this Brahmo Samaj, no doubt it was divided into two different parts, and further it was also divided into two different parts. Still, Brahmo Samaj brought political awakening in the people. It reformed the Hindu society. Both these sects, no doubt that they were different, they were got separated, they were splitted, yet they both have reformed the Hindu society. They were against the idol worship. Both have criticized the child marriage and the parda system. It denied that any scripture is beyond the human intellect. Both believe that human intellect, reasoning, is above than any written religious book. And both were in favor of women liberation. They wanted that the women should get education and there should be no parda system in the society. I hope you have understood till here. With the help of this explanation and internet, you are advised to make the notes of above topic. Thank you.